Subscribe and click the bell icon for the latest updates and notifications from the Indian Express.
I actually don't think this government has got the basic economic framework right. I think it's terribly confused about it. And I think you will see some interesting changes if this government comes back to power. I think much more autarky, even much more economic and techno-nationalism emerging. I think the three things that I would point to, which I think were promising, works in progress. So one, I think you have to give it to Mr. Modi that when he took power, he at least touched on a couple of issues that were politically not considered important, but which are actually very fundamental. For example, Swachh Bharat, right? And he also quickly grasped that that is not a something that can be achieved by quick administrative quick fix, right? This is a way, and I think it was brave of him to even venture in that issue, to be frankly. I mean, it's, you know, you'll see its results in maybe 10 to 15 years, but I think in a sense putting that, I think, on the agenda. I think the cooking gas story is a very powerful story, but it's limited by the fact that you still don't have purchasing power for the subsequent gas cylinder. But I think in a very, very concrete way, both from a public health point of view, from a pollution point of view, from a kind of energy point of view, and probably even from a political point of view, right? I think it was a very kind of smart and savvy thing to do. I think the IBC, right? In principle, I mean, now, of course, the whole thing is a big mess. But I think in principle, giving a signal to sections of Indian capital for the first time, right, that there are severe penalties and actually you can lose your companies. I mean, if you think about it, right, what kind of a capitalism this was where there were actually no penalties, right? That, however, its promise, I think, has been dimmed by creating other kinds of plutocratic structures, right, through electoral bonds, through other forms of concentration of economic powers. But I think those are three very promising things that still have the potential of bearing fruit if followed through.